This is an overview and demo of the DepsTech wireless endoscope. Here it is in the box with its accessories. The endoscope itself with 16.5 feet of cable. This is the end camera with 6 LEDs for illumination and a side camera with 1 LED for illumination. Nice instruction manual with accessories. You get a magnet and a hook for retrieving objects, a spare lens protector, and a reset tool for the unit itself. The ubiquitous USB cable. Here's the control box with on-off switch and LED illumination dial. You have 2 LEDs. The one on the right, the blue LED, is your Wi-Fi status, and the one on the left shows the unit is on or charging status. First, we need to load the app. You can get that from the App Store. It's called DepsTech View. We'll download it, get it installed. And we go into the app, and we'll bring the camera up. And this is the front view camera. And we'll hit the 90-degree indicator up in the corner, which rotates the image. We'll hit the camera, which takes a photo. We'll hit the video camera, which starts your video. We'll hit the folder button, which takes you to either pictures or videos. And then we have a settings button for resolution and your Wi-Fi setup. Okay, so that's again the front camera, and I'm switching to the side camera, which is pointing up at this point towards the ceiling. And then I'll switch again, and we get both front and side cameras at the same time. A nice feature. So this is the unit and the cable, which is rather stiff, which is good and in some cases not so good. It's good in the fact that it will certainly stay in place wherever you put it. The not so good part from in use that you will see is the fact that if you get to a tight spot or you need to move around something, it's somewhat difficult to do because it is so stiff. But in the end, it's better to have it that way than other. But it is very bendable and adjustable. So my first exploration was into my Honda with 346,000 miles. I thought I'd go under the valve cover and see how things looked. I was wondering if I had any sludge buildup of any kind. But I've been using Mobil 1 since the very early days in this motor. And as you can see, it is very clean inside. You can see some rollers on the rocker arms. You can see some camshaft lobes. All very clear. It is a little difficult to keep it perfectly steady, but it can be done. This is the inside of the valve cover itself, almost spotless. Okay. Next thing I thought I'd try would be a gas tank on my car. I'm going in, and this was a bit of a challenge because it's got ridges on the way down to give the downpipe some inner strength. And I never quite got to the part where the gas is actually held, but I decided to quit while I was ahead here and try something else. I went to my outdoor dryer vent duct and thought I'd explore up in there a little bit. So I'll go inside and start poking around, and there you go. You can see the duct, and of course, you're always concerned about lint buildup in there, but this looked pretty clear. So after poking around a little bit, I'm able to get some pretty good views. This is the front camera and the side camera at the same time. And you see a little bit in there, but it looks pretty good. And then here's a nice view here, and I'm amazed how sharp this camera is. It is 5 megapixel. So if you get it positioned right, you can get some amazing shots. And I believe this is with the side camera as well. So I've had a good time playing around with this unit. It's interesting and fun. And you can't beat the price. I got mine on Amazon for $67, I think. So if you think you'd enjoy something like this, check it out.